Before this video starts, I gotta give a huge shout out and sponsor to I Love Genie. Even though he's only on Discord and his channel was originally called PS4 Gamer, and he originally deleted it because he got in trouble, he just wants me to tell you guys that he's okay and he's quite well and he's still doing good as always. Other than that, enjoy the video.
Overnight, the world changed for everyone.
Working from home setups, kits, everything they need.
But these new challenges have fueled our passion for the mission.
This game should have been great. No matter how much free content Square Enix throws at this game, because at its core, Avengers is fundamentally broken.
A surprising amount of technical rough edges. There is a nugget of something cool here, but it's going to take more than Terrigen Mist to transform it into something that
was the final nail in the coffin. I take back every nice thing I said about Marvel's Avengers. This game cannot be saved.
I'm gonna be honest and realistic with you guys. I originally thought Marvel's Avengers would redeem itself and become a better game after Guardians of the Galaxy had a successful launch. And let me tell you, truthfully, I was wrong. I originally wished this game was gonna be successful soon as it had a little bit of its fair share of problems back in 2020. But after 2 years of getting backlash and hate on, I can confidently say and confirm, I've lost all hope in this game. It can't be saved. I'm absolutely done with it. I tried to be absolutely nice, everything about it, tried to respect its developers' manners, and I gotta say, I gave up hope. Now, I know I'd respect developers' manners like Sega, Nintendo's, other shenanigans, blah, 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 but here's the thing. I don't respect developers' manners if they don't even know on what the hell they're actually doing. Take this, for example. This is actually from one of my awesome YouTubers, one of my favorite YouTubers, Evan, so please go subscribe to him. He made a video, something about one of the developers saying something about, I'm pretty sure I'll celebrate it elsewhere. Somewhere, and therefore, will be a meal starring a turkey. But whether I'm at my place or my family's, which sides will be made? Will I bother to watch the football game or those admitting they feel like they'd be guesswork is fair out. And I'm sorry. I am sorry. What the hell is going on? This is something no other developer should have been doing by then. Hey Square, I don't even know what you're doing or someone at Crystal Dynamics needs to explain, but what the hell's going on? Oh, and yes, the article that Square Enix officially sold Tomb Raider for NFTs and also getting into NFTs too much. Finally, and also, how on earth did I didn't recognize this 3 days ago? Oops, sorry. Square Enix Marvel's Games needs Disney's approval to continue Embracer and its and players are worried. Like, there's people out there that still play Marvel's Avengers. And you know what, to that, I respect them for that. But the thing is, Square Enix needs to get their shit together, or something bad's gonna happen. But as for Square Enix right now, they're doing a lot of terrible decisions. To me, I find these decisions 10 times worse than Nintendo's broken DMCA bot. Which is another truthful fact of my own that people agree with me with, actually, surprisingly. However, let's just say at this point, Square Enix just kindly digged their own grave at this point. Square Enix lost $2,000 million on Marvel games. Avengers will transfer to Ambassador Group. So, yeah. I think this explains the whole Disney needing approval part. So, this is kind of surprising. So, we have a bunch of questions that will remain. Will Square Enix continue the Marvel rights after Guardians of the Galaxy's success and keep Avengers going and keep its respectful fan base from moving on? Or is this game going to be shut down, Square Enix getting a boot to the ass by Disney and other stuff? Short, realistic answer, I don't know. Or, however, I should say accurately, I don't care. And we don't care about Marvel's Avengers. And I'm starting to move on at this point. Funny, interesting story. I was actually this close to getting Marvel's Avengers on my own. This close. After someone convinced me. But thankfully, my honest, badass fan base told me, don't do it, it's a trap. No, 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 no. And let me tell you, I am very thankful to have a truthful, respectful, honest fan base. Look at them all. Look how all of them are truthful and serious. You know, real soon, if I save enough cash, I'm actually thinking about getting this suit and doing a review on it while flipping the bird off to Square Enix for fun. Because that would be even cool. You know, actually, by the looks of it, this suit does look better than the gaming counterpart, I will admit. Maybe it will come up, or maybe I will buy it eventually. But in time, who knows? I'm gonna probably do it anyway once I earn some cash. So, Square, either do something once in your fruitless life and get your crap together and fix up your reputation, or alternatively, lose the Marvel's Avengers rights and make a freaking apology video, just like how Cyberpunk 2077 did. While Cyberpunk 2077 did have its huge flaws and failures, but thankfully, after 2 years of lying to its fans and lying to the gaming industry and basically screwing them up from the get-go, I can fairly say that I actually forgive Cyberpunk a tiny bit. I'm not going to buy its game, but I will see more people playing it and other stuff. When I first saw this Cyberpunk, I thought it was a good game. So I would rather give Cyberpunk a respectful pass, while I give Square Enix themselves, a boot to the ass. Sorry about that middle finger part. Well, Square, either get your shit together, or there's gonna be huge consequences. Your choice. You know, I'm just very thankful that Smash Nintendo gave us both Cloud, Sephiroth, and Sora in Smash Bros. Just in case if Square Enix does something terrible bad. I mean, I could definitely see why Sora and Mario like each other, surprisingly. Hurricane, Square Enix kinda screwed themselves up from the get-go. Well, other than that, hope you guys liked this video, subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys in the next video, so peace out.